Hi, it's Phil from smilinggardener.com, and today I'm talking about organic fertilizers, and now I want to get into fish. And a fish is a really wonderful fertilizer. You want to have an ocean fish fertilizer because that's where the nutrients are. And really what I want to get into today, I use when I do use fish, which is not that much anymore, but I'll use a liquid fertilizer, and there's two main kinds. There's an emulsion and a hydrolysate, and I want to go into the difference between those. So an emulsion is pretty common, and what it is generally, usually, is it's the parts of the fish that aren't used for other things, like the bones and the head and the guts and things that aren't used elsewhere. And those are taken and cooked at pretty hot temperatures to kill off any bacteria, microorganisms, and then it's going to be filtered and stabilized with sulfuric acid or phosphoric acid. So it, because it's cooked, it doesn't retain a lot of the beneficial, the oils, the proteins, the vitamins, the enzymes, they're killed off. Or if they aren't killed off in the cooking temperature, they will have been removed in certain parts of the fish that have been used for, we use fish for weird things like makeup and all kinds of kind of strange things. So it's often going to be a lower quality product than a hydrolysate. It's still useful though. If you do get that, you want to make sure you want to get one that's organic, because sometimes they're spiked with chemicals. So you want one that's organic. It's still good, but not as good as a hydrolysate. What a hydrolysate usually is it's bycatch. So it's a whole fish, but it's the fish that are caught by accident that aren't going to be used in aren't the fish that they're looking for when they're fishing. So these are the bycatch, and they what they'll do now is they'll take that whole fish, digest it at a cold temperature with enzymes, then they'll grind that up and liquefy it. It'll still be stabilized, usually with phosphoric acid, which I prefer to the sulfuric. And then it's going to retain the oils, and the proteins are going to stay, and you know they're not going to get denatured. And you'll have your live enzymes and vitamins. And so it's usually going to be a higher quality product. And so that's the one that when I have used fish, I have used it. But overall, either way, fish is a very nutritious product because it comes from the ocean again, and there's lots of nutrients there. But the nice thing about fish over something like kelp and sea minerals is it has quite a good nitrogen content and available phosphorus content. And because they put that little bit of phosphoric acid in there often, especially in the hydrolysates, that's a really good source of phosphorus. And that is a chemical, and I don't really advocate for many chemicals, but that's one. They might just put, say, a couple percent in there. It's just going to be a couple percent of the final product, and it's going to be a really good source of phosphorus. The fish is really nice when you need that nitrogen source, maybe when you're trying to start some fruit promotion on, in the middle of the summer, or there are certain plants that really need your nitrogen, and phosphorus is really important too. So that's what I have, in the past, I've liked the fish for. Now, in terms of sustainability, this is where it becomes more of an issue. I've certainly looked into the sustainability a lot of fish, and when I used to sell organic fertilizers and I sold it, I found a product that seemed to me that they were doing a good job. They were trying to get, I forget what it's called now, but certification from the Marine Stewardship Council or something. They were trying to do a good job. But I'm just concerned that, you know, we've lost over 90% of the big fish in the sea. We're overfishing. And so I just think we need to, it'd be nice if we could find a way to fish more sustainably, but we have over 7 billion people and I don't know if it's possible anymore. So I don't eat fish anymore. I'm concerned about the health of the oceans. I'm concerned about toxicity in the fish, mercury and heavy metals and all kinds of chemicals. And so I'm kind of at that point where I don't buy it anymore. I still have some in stock and that's why I've been using it this year. And the reason I'm mentioning it today is because I have seen a lot of good benefits from it this year and in past years. And I'm really not buying it anymore. I'm going more to the sea mineral products now. It doesn't have quite the high nitrogen and phosphorus content, but it is a really wonderful product. I think it's the best product. I think it is better than fish and it's more sustainable. And that's what I'm using more now. But I did want to mention the fish because it is a popular one. So if you want to learn more about how much to use and how much it costs and things like that, I will post a link to that below, assuming you're not already on my website.